What the fuck is that?
Yeah.
Done.
turn to fucking auto. It's already hurt.
Hey.
Where?
Oh, innocent. Nur den Ding.
Precious. What kind of life is she gonna have if I never go near her again? It's just, sometimes it feels like the only things I've got in life are Nat and the paper. Having someone I can count on, someone like you, it's meant a lot to me. Not a lot of people want to hang around with the nosy reporter.
Hey, I'm listening. Okay, this is what I've got.
Yeah, but you're my kind of nosy.
You're the exception. I haven't exactly made a lot of friends in this career. I just wanted to right the things I thought were wrong. And when Nat and I first got to Diamond City, there was a lot of wrong. Crooked guards, lousy infrastructure. There was a hole in the exterior wall that was patched over with a bookcase. One bookcase. That's it. I started the paper more as an act of desperation than anything else. Turned out I wasn't the only one who wanted things to change. After the first couple of editions, people may not have agreed with what I said, but everyone was listening.
Sounds like you really cleaned up Diamond City.
Well, a lot of things got done. They even put a second bookshelf over that hole and patched it with bricks. When that first edition hit the stands, I felt like I'd finally done something worth doing. But afterwards, things changed. People didn't want to talk the way they used to. It seemed that overnight I'd gone from being Piper, friend and confidant, to Piper, the nosy snoop. A lot of folks, they haven't treated me the same since. It started to feel like the only person I could count on was my little sis.
You can count on me, Piper.
I know I can. You're not afraid of me like everyone else. I was sure that the paper would be the best thing I ever did in my life, but being here with you now I don't know. I've needed someone like you in my life for a long time, Lou. I just never expected I'd actually get them. So thank you for being the friend I can count on.
It sounds to me like you're interested in becoming more than just friends.
Oh, I mean, I'd be lying if I said I never thought about you that way. Not that I'm always thinking that way. It's just, Blue, I'm loud and pushy and constantly getting in over my head. Why would someone like you ever want someone like me?
You don't need to be flawless, Piper. You're perfect for me.
Perfect, huh? That's a new one. Well, I think you're perfect too. Goodness, Blue, I don't know what to say. You're everything I could ever ask for. Come on, let's not keep the world waiting.
showed your face. I take it that area's clear. Affirmative. Looks like I got my surprise for the day. Yeah. Now report to Paladin Dance. He said he had a mission for you. When you're ready for another op, you know where to find me. Another mission.
We've seen better days, haven't it?
Ready. Outstanding. Over the years, the Brotherhood has sent several recon teams to the Commonwealth. The last squad went in 3 years ago. They never reported back. Officially, they're missing, presumed dead. I'm sorry. Don't be. Everyone who signs up for a recon mission knows what to expect. Our lives depend on our training and on each other. And if we should fall, the Brotherhood will honor our memory. We have a responsibility to find out what happened to them, if we can. All right, I'll see to it. Their insertion point was in the hills near Malden. Survey the area and establish a search pattern. Monitor your radio for distress signals. All recon teams are issued distress pulsers that put out a short-range homing beacon. If you can acquire a signal, you should be able to trace it to its source.
That's probably me just trying to find
Heads up.
Help yourself.
Look alive.
What can I do?
Nothing I hate more than raider scumbags. If you...
some more.